And that is the monetary policy the U.S. is pursuing. If something goes wrong, print. If it doesn't get fixed, print more.
In February of 2006, Robert Mugabe directed the Zimbabwe Reserve Bank to print $20.5 trillion to buy foreign currency to pay off IMF debt. This caused prices of consumer goods to go through the roof, and in May of 2006, the Zimbabwe government announced they would print an additional $60 trillion to pay for a 300% salary increase for the soldiers and policemen. In August of 2006, three zeros were chopped off the currency to form a new Zimbabwe dollar. And in June of 2007, $1 trillion of the new currency was printed to pay for a 900% salary increase for the soldiers and policemen. In July of 2007, Mugabe implemented price controls which forced stores to sell goods at government-ordered prices. This led the nation to complete chaos and empty store shelves. Mugabe's solution was to print more money, and in February of 2008, the total Zimbabwe money supply reached $800 trillion. By July of 2008, it cost $100 billion just to buy three eggs. In April of 2009, the Zimbabwe currency was officially declared dead and completely worthless. Zimbabweans were forced to transact in gold.
If you need cooking oil, you have to exchange with gold. If you need millimeter, you have to exchange it with gold. If you need soap, you have to change with gold. Everything is gold, gold, no Zimbabwean dollars.
Gold has been universally accepted as real money for thousands of years. Unlike fiat currencies, gold can't be printed out of thin air. Gold is expensive to mine, and its supply will always be scarce. In 1980, the last time the United States had an inflationary crisis like the one we are rapidly approaching, gold prices surged to an inflation-adjusted high of $2,300 per ounce. Federal Reserve Chairman Paul Volcker was able to get inflation under control by raising interest rates to a high of 21.5%. Back then, we were the world's largest creditor nation. Today, we are the world's largest debtor nation, with a national debt of $11.4 trillion. The Federal Reserve is forced to raise interest rates up to 21.5% once again. Just the interest on our national debt will be over $2.4 trillion per year. This is a death sentence for the American taxpayer. The United States may have an annual GDP of $14 trillion, but more than 70% of it is consumer spending. The only way it will be possible for the United States to pay off its debt is by monetizing it and effectively printing the money out of thin air. The national debt is not our only major problem. Unfunded liabilities for Social Security and Medicare and Medicaid are now $55 trillion. Up until now, the Social Security system has worked like a Ponzi scheme, not unlike the one that was run by Bernie Madoff. Americans with jobs are paying into Social Security to fund those who are receiving benefits. With the retirement of the baby boomers, the Social Security house of cards is coming to an end.
Our dollar today is worth 4 cents compared to the dollar of 1913 when the Federal Reserve took in charge of it. And if you don't deal with the dollar, there will be no retirement for anybody. We're going to have chaos. And that is why you have to cut spending. That's why we need a new foreign policy. We need to tie the people over here in this country, the people who are dependent, but we need to let the people get out, whether it's Social Security or medical care or education. The Constitution doesn't advise that we do any of that anyway. That's the only way we can solve the problem.
Throughout history, the United States has had cyclical periods where paper assets, like stocks, are in favor, and other periods when hard assets, like gold, perform better than stocks. The long-term battle between stocks and gold is illustrated by looking at a chart of the Dow to Gold Ratio, which is the price of the Dow Jones Stock Index divided by the price of gold. After reaching a high of 44 in 1999, the Dow to Gold Ratio has been in free fall to its current level of 9. If the Dow to Gold Ratio bottoms once again at 1 like it did in 1980, we are looking at another 90% decline in the price of stocks when priced in gold.
The Dow is going to be worth 1 ounce of gold. That's the level. So right now, gold is worth $900 an ounce, and the Dow is at 12,000. Those two numbers are going to meet somewhere. I don't know where, but they're going to meet.
Silver prices have the potential to surge by an even greater percentage than gold. The Coinage Act of 1834 established a gold-to-silver ratio of 16 to 1, which lasted until silver was demonetized in 1874. The gold-to-silver ratio is currently close to 70, which means silver is receiving almost no monetary premium. During periods of high inflation, the gold-to-silver ratio tends to move back to 16, as it did in 1980. Imagine if the Dow-to-gold ratio returns to 1, and the gold-to-silver ratio returns to 16 at the same time. If the Dow and gold met at the median of their current values, we'd be looking at $4,700 per ounce gold and $294 per ounce silver. That would represent a 2,000% increase in the price of silver from its current level of $14 per ounce.
Hyperinflation is the plan of the elite. What you have just watched is the plan of the elite, whereby they will own and take over everything. I have a message for them. I have no intentions in being we the sheeple. I'm going to be we the people, which I was guaranteed by the first words of the Constitution of the United States of America. I will be we the people, and we will not be we the sheeple. Now, we're going to go into some things in DVD number 3 that you've got to see, because their ultimate control factor is war. When will it happen and where? I've been told. Now, I know that you won't believe me until a year and a half to 2 years from now. And you're going to come back and say, Lindsey Williams is a prophet. You know what I'm going to tell you? No, I'm not. I claim no prophetic intuition whatsoever. I claim only that by the providence of God, I was allowed to live with the elite for 3 years, keep in touch with some of them for the past 35 years, and still hear from some who are old men now and are too old to care, and say, tell the world everything you know, Chaplain. So in the next DVD, we're going into war. When and where, and can it happen all across America as it did in Detroit? I hope that you will watch DVD number 3. And thank you for allowing me to be in your home to tell you what I was told just a short while ago.